This plan will help you focus on the actions you'll take and assets you'll need to develop and grow. Hey, Ferris here, and we're continuing our business plan mini-series. In the previous video, we covered the first three components of a business plan: the executive summary, organization and management, and market analysis. Now we'll look at the last three sections and everything they should cover. Let's dive in. Up next is the product and service section. Here, you want to expand on what you're offering. What's so unique about it? Why will your target audience or audiences be ecstatic about it? Maybe you have a patent, mention that here. If you had a side hustle delivering your product or service, mention customer feedback and reviews, hopefully all positive. If not, you need to address how and what you'll fix and improve to address the issues. If your design or delivery cycle is long, ensure your plan calls out key milestones and phases, and what's needed to achieve each milestone and the expected outcome. Definitely emphasize the product or service differentiator, but don't go overboard. After product and service comes financial projections. When it comes to this section, let me highlight two common scenarios. First, you've been in business for a while, and now you're writing a business plan to grow or maybe pivot. Leverage that historical data you have, your knowledge about the sales cycle and seasonality, what worked and what didn't in marketing, as well as cost of delivery and pricing. In the other scenario, you're starting fresh, writing the plan before or as you're starting. As mentioned previously, you're going to make a lot of assumptions. The important thing is to start with a baseline, like the next 12 months of revenue, expenses, and margin. On the revenue side, include your pricing strategy, tiered pricing, recurring revenue potential, and client retention targets. You'll also want to plan and demonstrate how you're scaling your sales, including all expenses associated with supporting that sales growth, such as hiring your first salesperson or accelerating your marketing efforts. Take into consideration lead time to close a deal and also the timeline of when customers will pay, and enter all this into your financial model. On the expenses side, you'll also have to make a lot of assumptions for things like rent, insurance, legal fees, and eventually salaries, benefits, and bonuses. Make sure to match the revenue with the expected expenses. By the way, this all can be done in Google Sheets or Excel. Whatever you do, be thorough, realistic, transparent, and err on the side of being conservative with all of your assumptions. And of course, if you're looking for funding to run the company, explicitly state how and when the funds will be used and how the funding will be treated. Write whether it'll be treated as debt or equity or maybe a mix. And definitely include a clear exit strategy. At the end of your plan, cover sales and marketing, which can be combined into one section or treated separately. The idea here is to identify both the marketing strategy as well as the marketing tactics you'll deploy. We've covered some of the fundamental marketing strategy components earlier under market analysis in the previous episode. Know your target audience and your competitors. In addition to those, this section should include estimates for marketing spend, paid media and paid ads versus organic and guerrilla marketing, the various marketing channels and associated efforts and costs you'll employ. For online businesses, list the strategy for generating website and mobile app traffic and how you'll convert visitors to leads and customers. And don't forget content. What's your content strategy? Are you going to write and produce the content yourself, or are you going to hire for it? And in what format? Blog, video, podcast, or email, or newsletters. Now that you've documented your marketing plan and your lead generation programs, you'll also need to document what it takes to close deals. What's your sales cycle going to look like? Who will follow up on leads? What sales assets you have? The pricing, discounts, pitches, sales slide deck, proposal templates, and references. And along the lines of all of that, add what marketing technology or MarTech you'll use for lead capturing, lead nurturing, content delivery, as well as customer relationship management, CRM. Add solid sales operations processes to manage leads, opportunities, and deals. Finally, what's your measurement strategy? Make sure you include how you plan on measuring the effectiveness of your various campaigns. Wow, that's a lot. But going through all of this effort will clarify what's needed for you and build confidence in investors. Don't worry, we will continue to elaborate on these processes as we go into future episodes, so make sure you follow along. The last section of the business plan is exhibits. So this is where you'll back up your claims, provide additional detail, certifications, patents, detailed research documents, and detailed financial modeling, whatever is applicable. If the plan is the argument for funding, the exhibits are the evidence to close the case. There you have it, the essential items you need to make your business plan complete. Demonstrate your competence and clarify your thinking around the little details you need in place to make your business successful. We've covered why a plan is essential, as well as the sections needed and the information to include. Again, if only for your eyes, this plan will help you focus on the actions you'll take and assets you'll need to develop and grow. And if or when you need additional funding, the plan provides the details potential investors need, even if the investors have been your best friend since kindergarten. And now it's time to give back. As you're thinking about differentiating your product and offerings and creating financial projections, offer to consult nonprofits in similar areas or processes you've mastered. For ideas on what nonprofits are looking for, check out catchfire.org, a website that matches volunteers with opportunities. Before we go, please comment below if you have any questions about business planning or any part of starting a business. I'd love to hear from you. Don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to this channel.